Welcome to iLecture Online. Let's take another look at our atmosphere. Turns out the atmosphere consists of four distinct layers. It's not that the consistency or what the atmosphere is made out of changes in each layer, but there are some distinct differences. The first layer is called the troposphere, the second layer is called the stratosphere, the third layer is called the mesosphere, and the upper layer is called the thermosphere. Sometimes you will also hear it as being called the ionosphere because that's where ions are being generated by the high energy radiation, X-rays and gamma rays that enter our atmosphere from outer space. Here you can see the approximate thickness of each layer. The troposphere, starting at the surface of the Earth, goes up to about 12 kilometers, which is about 7.5 miles up. The troposphere is basically where all weather occurs, all clouds, thunderstorms, all the weather, the rain, everything happens in the troposphere. The travel by jet, by passenger jet, also happens within the troposphere, and only high-performance military jets can make it up into the stratosphere. The stratosphere starts up at about 7.5 miles or 12 kilometers and goes all the way up to about a height of 50 kilometers, which is about 30 miles. It is within the stratosphere that we have the ozone layer, the layer that protects us against the low energy UV radiation. From about 50 kilometers to about 80 kilometers, we have what we call the mesosphere, and then above 80 kilometers, which is getting pretty close to being out in space, the ionosphere starts, or what we call the thermosphere. The ionosphere technically is the lower portion of the thermosphere. So why the different layers? Well, it turns out that if you look at the temperature at the various layers, notice that the Earth's temperature, and it's probably more like about an average temperature of about 15 degrees centigrade on the Earth's surface, you can see that as you go higher and higher up in elevation, the temperature drops rather quickly. That's called the lapse rate. Most of us that have been to mountainous areas know that if you go higher and higher in elevation, the temperatures drop quite a bit. So does the temperature in the troposphere, and by the time you reach the very top of the troposphere, which is about 12 kilometers high, that's the very highest place where the jetliners fly, temperatures will drop to about minus 60 degrees centigrade, which is quite cold. But then, strangely enough, the temperatures begin to increase again. Even though the air begins to be extremely rarefied, the atmosphere gets to be really, really thin, as you go higher and higher up in the stratosphere, you can see that the temperature begins to increase again and reaches a temperature of about 0 degrees at an altitude of about 50 kilometers or 30 miles. Now, that doesn't mean that it's relatively warm there compared to, of course, minus 60 degrees centigrade. It's only so due to the motion and the speed of the molecules that is basically a theoretical temperature. Of course, if you're 50 kilometers up in the atmosphere, you would need a special spacesuit to stay alive, because it's not the temperature that would kill you, but the rarefied air that would kill you. 0 degrees centigrade is still a much higher temperature than minus 60. Why is that? Primarily because in the stratosphere we have the ozone layer, and all that UV radiation that otherwise would make it all the way down to the surface of the Earth gets intercepted by the ozone layer, by the O3 molecules in the atmosphere, and that energy absorbed and heats up the atmosphere in that particular region. There's very little convection currents. So basically, we can say no convection currents. And since there's no convection currents in that region of the atmosphere, whatever heat gets absorbed due to the incoming UV radiation that gets absorbed by the ozone layer then heats up that layer, and that heat then stays there enough for the temperature to reach as much as 0 degrees centigrade. Then if you go above that layer where the ozone layer is not in existence, then you can see the temperature begins to drop again, and it drops all the way down to about minus 90 degrees centigrade by the time we reach the very top of the mesosphere, which is at a height of about 80 kilometers or 50 miles. At that point, the temperature begins to increase again, and they call this a thermosphere for a very good reason, because that layer of the atmosphere begins to be very, very warm. Again, don't go up there expecting to be able to sunbathe up there, because it's extremely far off the surface of the Earth. The air is extremely thin and there's almost no atmosphere to keep you warm. Nevertheless, the temperature of the atmosphere, theoretically, because the molecules move at very high velocities there, they do so because they absorb all the X-rays and gamma ray radiation and high energy UV radiation that comes in from space. They absorb the nitrogen and oxygen in the atmosphere, absorbs that radiation, and therefore the temperature increases to very large, very high temperatures, well above the temperature on the surface of the Earth. Again, only in theory, because if you go up there, it will still appear to be very cold because, of course, there's so little of the atmosphere there. Beyond the ionosphere, if you go further up, the thermosphere keeps on increasing in temperature to a certain height, and then you finally reach a place at about 100 kilometers where the exosphere starts. So a distance from 100 kilometers up to about 700 kilometers, there we have the very, very outer layer of the atmosphere. It's technically no longer part of our atmosphere, but the reason why we still want to consider it is because there's still a fair amount of very rarefied air molecules at these very high elevations. Spacecraft like satellites and things like that that orbit the Earth will bounce up or intercept these small little particles, and over time will cause a small amount of drag on satellites. Over the tens and hundreds of years, it may slow down satellites enough to make them slowly drop in altitude, and perhaps in the future even come back down to the surface of the Earth. But the exosphere is so rarefied that the amount of atmosphere there is almost non-existent. It goes all the way up to about 700 kilometers, where you can then say that the effect of the atmosphere is pretty well completely negated, and then you're far above the Earth's atmosphere and into space where the atmosphere is no longer plays an effect in that region. The main layers of the atmosphere, the troposphere, the stratosphere, the mesosphere, and the ionosphere, you go beyond that, you're in space, and you consider there to be virtually no atmosphere left. That's how we can characterize the atmosphere of the Earth.